Hello and welcome back. I am Rajesh Argiddi from CSE Department of Doubly at Solapur. Today we'll focus on data structure topic, that is linked list, in which we have singly linked list, doubly linked list, singly circular linked list and doubly circular linked list. Let us focus on doubly linked list. The learning outcome of today's video: at the end of the session, student will be able to explain the doubly linked list data structures. Let us see what is doubly linked list. It is a linked list which has two pointers through which the list can be traversed in both directions, that is in forward direction and in the reverse direction. As we know that in singly linked list, the traversal was in only forward direction. So we used to traverse only one direction, but in doubly linked list, we can traverse forward as well as reverse. Doubly linked list provides a natural implementation of the list abstract data type. Nodes in the doubly linked list store three parts. The first part is called as a data or element. Second is called as a link to the previous node, and third is called as a link to the next node. In data or element, whatever the data we want to store, it may be integer, character or any data type, that can be stored in the data part. And these two links, link to the previous node and link to the next node. Let us look at this diagram. If you look at this diagram, the middle part, which will store the data, actual data, may be the integer, character, float, double, and the left part of this data, which left part has called as a previous, and the right part of this data is called as a next. This previous means that it is the storing the address of the previous node, or it is a link provided to the previous node. And this part will store the address of the next node, or it is link addressing to the next node. So in a list, suppose there are more number of nodes are there. So every node will have previous link and next link, data part and element part. This is called as a node. Now if you look at the entire linked list, it will look like this. There are five nodes are there. The first node, which stores the value 10, second stores the value 20, third stores the value 30, and the fourth one stores 440. Means only four nodes are there, not five. So these are called the nodes. So middle part will be storing the actual element or a data part. Now every node has two pointers, that is linked to the previous node. This is linked to the previous node. Now since it is the first node of the list, which will be pointing to the header part, which will store the address of the entire list. And the right part of this 10 data, which will store the address of the next node, that is 20. Similarly, this 20 node will have three parts. In the middle part, it will be storing the data 20, and the left part, which will be linked to the previous node, that is the first node, and on the right hand side, this will be storing the link to the next node, that is third node. Similarly, third and fourth are stored in this way, and in the last node there is a data called as a data 40 stored, and left link is having address of the previous node, that is third node, and here it will be storing the address of the next node. Since it is a last node, it will be addressing to the trailer. It will be addressing to the trailer node, which will store the address of this particular node. And this header part is also storing the address of the entire, the first node of the address of the first node. So special header and tailers nodes are used to denote head and tail positions in the linked list. Now, sentinel nodes, to simplify programming, two special nodes have been added to both ends of the doubly linked list. Head and tail are dummy nodes, also called as the sentinels, do not store any data elements. So this is called as a header node. Header sentinel has a null previous reference link, and this particular part of the list is called as a trailer or tail. Trailer sentinel has a null next reference link. Now go to the next slide. Doubly linked list structure and pointers. A doubly linked list object would need to store the following. It will store reference to the sentinel head node, that is address of the head node will store the address of the list first node, reference to the sentinel tail nodes, then size counter that keeps track of the number of nodes in the list excluding the two sentinels. Now empty doubly linked list. Empty doubly linked list, let us see what is empty. It means that there will not be any nodes, no data part will be there. Using sentinels, we have no null links. Instead, we have head dot next is equal to tail, this one, and tail dot previous is equal to head. Now this diagram shows that the links are provided from header to tailer and trailer to header. There is no node between these two, header and trailer. It means that this list is empty list. Now a single node in a doubly linked list, the size is equal to 1. Here shows that header is there in a list and trailer is also there. In between we have one node is there. In one node, the middle part will be storing the data part or element is stored, and this will addressing, or it will store the address of the header, and this will be storing the address of the trailer. So the single linked list, the single node is the first node and also the last node. First node is called head dot next, and last node is called as a tail dot previous. Reflection spot. The question based on this particular topic, the header pointer points to the dash node in the doubly linked list. Take a pause over here, answer the question. The answer is the header pointer points to the first node in the doubly linked list. This is header part which will be storing the address of the first node, address of this particular node where the data 10 is stored. Now in this, again the same example is there, four nodes are there, and this is a trailer part which will be storing the address of the last node. Doubly linked list node creation. How to create a node? For that we have to define one structure named as a node. The variable name of structure is node. It consists of three parts. The first part is data part, and the two parts are the pointers which will be pointing to the next node and the pointer which will be pointing to the previous node. Now the first part, that is data type, is integer, means only integer can be stored in the data part, and here the pointer is declared saying that node star next. It means that it will be storing the address of the next node, pointer to the next node in a doubly linked list. This struct node star previous is pointer to the previous node in a doubly linked list. Now let us see what are the advantages of doubly linked list over the singly linked list. List can be traversed in two directions, in forward as well as in backward. It is easy to, for traversal and applications like searching. Quick update operations such as insertion, deletion at both ends, head and tail, and also at the middle of the list. In a singly linked list, only in one direction we can go. We cannot go in the reverse direction. These are the references. I hope you understood the concept of doubly linked list. Thank you for watching this video.